located around 130 miles away from Death Valley, sits what we know as a little place known as Sin City. Where the house always wins. Ladies and gentlemen, this is Las Vegas, baby. $42.52 million people a year find escapism in Vegas. And in the next 24 hours, team stylist Dayle and I are gonna be two of them. There are over 441 casinos in Vegas and well over 155,000 hotel rooms. The city really does feel like an adult's theme park, where you can meet anyone at any time.
Vegas. At London.
Oh my god, yeah.
Yeah. What's your number?
But let me start at the beginning. We touched down from a 1 hour flight from Los Angeles. This was my second time in Vegas, and Dayle's first. We had one hell of a week before. Here's why. We were working with Graham on his 7 day transformation week, focusing on his style, his dating technique, and while basically giving him one of the best experiences of his life. We really pushed him. And my God, did he have a good time. You get the idea. Shortly after we finished with Graham, we rolled out my Impactful Connections workshop. Guys flew in from all over the states to develop their skill set.
Go, do, right? So if you see, you're not gonna find all of those visions.
Each of the students really threw themselves at it. Everyone broke through their sticking points, and of course, the King of Cool was there to hand out his pearls of wisdom on styling and fashion.
Regardless of what it is, you know, I never feel underdressed or overdressed for one.
All in all, it was a really positive week. So after a week like that, I thought, fuck it, let's hit Vegas. We arrive at the apartment. I won't go on to talk about who won at that game. Next, we hit the road to set off to meet one of my old friends. Someone who was one of the original guys that I learned a lot of stuff from some 15 years ago. Mr. Johnny Soporno. Not Soprano, Soporno. Johnny has been in the seduction industry his whole life. Teaching his lifestyle and seductive reasoning model, Johnny offers some really unique perspectives on polyamory and open relationships.
Because when a woman refers to another woman as a slut, she's actually saying, you're a traitor to your gender. You're a scab to the union of women. You're making sex available for less than the value of security.
He's in a loving open relationship with his partner, Violet, who he met during his days as a pornography director. Now you're starting to see where his name comes from. It was really cool to be welcomed into Johnny's home and see a side of him that not a lot of people normally get to see. He was playful, cheeky, and not short of a fun fact or hilarious story. Johnny is one big character. After showing us around the grounds of his beautiful house, we got set up and jumped straight into what would turn out to be one of the most interesting interviews that I've ever done.
In the beginning, there was nothing. And God said, let there be light. And there was still nothing, only now you could see it.
But I think I've heard you say something about this in terms of how marriage is just arguably prostitution.
Well, I'll follow this down.
Right.
In our culture, as a good general case, we have no respect for the slut, virtually no respect for the whore, but we give her an out.
We talked all the way into the night.
By the way,
just when I thought we were done, Johnny comes out with this.
We should all have a hot tub shortly.
Yeah, I'll have a hot tub. Why not? It was during this time Johnny opened up and was at his most vulnerable. It really did feel that bearing it all had brought us closer together.
We are at the shooting range.
We then do what all great Americans do. Fire guns. Look at us. We look like unlockable characters in Grand Theft Auto. There is over $6.4 billion generated on the strip alone. Here is a moment where I bumped into some guests who were attending the Latin Grammys, including Johnny, Miss Venezuela.
At London.
Oh my God, yeah.
Yeah. Well, you're a phenomenal example.
This trip made me realize what I enjoyed about this city before. I loved exploring new and old places. It really is America's playground, a city where anything is possible.
You can get anything in Vegas.
Like I just said, anything is possible. We got past on that. Vegas is the most colorful, vibrant city that you'll probably ever go to. In terms of entertainment, it's just the gift that keeps on giving. Now, needless to say, I'm not a natural gambler.
Why make a gamble on you pulling a particular bird, maybe, but like...
In Vegas, opportunities are everywhere. You can be in a casino.
What's your story?
You could be in the restaurant. Literally anywhere.
Wow, so you have more tricks up your sleeve than I thought. Wow, that's very bold of you.
Well, I think it'd be absolute travesty if we didn't.
Okay, why? Right. Do you have any good ideas?
I have lots.
Me and Snoop Dogg at Hackasan. As we headed home, I thought to myself, Vegas will be back.